Hi, I'm Karen Greta from Scandinavia, and today we're getting close to the Christmas time, and because of that I am going to make marzipan. And I have all the ingredients here in front of me. So here, as you can tell, I already took the skin off a bunch of the almonds. I have 2 cups of almonds. And here is all the almond peel. I have some almonds. I'm showing you how I got the skin off. I put boiling water on the almonds and I leave them for a couple of minutes like this. And after that, the peel should be loose. As you can tell right now, it's not loose enough. So I have to leave it in there for, like I said, about a few minutes. And then I'll show you how I can take off the peel real easy. All right, so here you can tell the water is steaming. And yes, the peel slides off so easy. If you keep sliding off, eventually maybe the almonds get too cold and you might have to reheat the water and pour boiling water on it again. So there, you see how I do that. But now I'm going to mix all the ingredients, and I'm going to put it in my blender here. Now, when you grind the almonds, I suggest you put a little bit in at a time, because otherwise it seems like it doesn't. If you put too much in the grinder at the time, they won't all grind up and you have to take some out and leave some in. So it's easier just to put a little bit of it in, and you see it's all finished. Pour it out. And here is the last portion I'm putting. All right, should be just perfect now. And actually, to the 2 cups of almonds I've been grinding, I'm going to add a cupful of powdered sugar. And let me put some of it in here now. And later on, I'm going to add a little bit of water, and also I like to add a little bit of almond flavor. It just kind of enhances the flavor of the marzipan. Or if you have a bitter almond, I would suggest you add 1 bitter almond to the portion. But I don't happen to have that today, so I'm using the almond flavor. Pour it all together. I'm going to mix it all up. I'm now adding the rest of the powdered sugar, mixing it up with the ground almonds. And actually, I'll add just a little bit of water. Let's see, I'll add a spoonful at a time. You don't want too much water. You just want to make sure it can all stick together. And like I said, I'm going to add some almond extract. And I am going to add 1/2 teaspoon. And again, you can, after you have mixed it all up and you tasted it, you can judge if you want a little bit more almond flavor in there. That could be. But that's a nice touch, I think. Okay, another spoonful of water. Because you don't want too much water. You just want to make sure it all sticks together. And of course, now I'm starting to use my hand because it tells you, you can feel how much more, if you need any more water. And it's almost right. I would say it is probably just perfect with the 2 tablespoons of water. Yeah. I'm now going to kneaded on the table. Add a little bit more powdered sugar. And I have a really nice portion of marzipan here. Oh, I look forward to using it. I'm going to use it for baking, and of course you can also make marzipan confect. I mean, it seems like we have to have marzipan for Christmas, or something is missing. So here you see I have a nice loaf of marzipan. And it was actually pretty easy to make. If you don't want to make it yourself, you can probably buy it in the store. Not all stores have it, but hopefully you can find it. So here is my marzipan all ready to go for the next project. I hope you're going to try to make some marzipan yourself. And happy holidays. Here I also have a Christmas calendar. Hopefully the children in your family have received the Christmas calendar already, so they can open a little door or window every day before Christmas. My children always enjoyed it, and of course now my grandchildren are getting a Christmas calendar. Happy holidays! Please subscribe to our channel.